Hi everyone, I am very happy to welcome you all to Dr. JJS Virtual Academy of Commerce. In this video, I am going to discuss with you a problem which requires the calculation of funds from operations. Let us get into the details of the problem. A company's current year profit is 70,000 rupees after considering the following. So the profit has been calculated after considering the following accounting information. Number one, loss on sale of equipment 10,000. Number two, premium on redemption of debentures, which would have been adjusted through the profit and loss account 1,500. Discount on issue of debentures written off 2,000 rupees. Then depreciation on machinery 20,000. Depletion of natural resources 10,000. Amortization of goodwill 30,000 rupees. Interim dividend 25,000 rupees. Now let's move to the other items that are presented here. Gain from sale of non-current assets 40,000 rupees, excess provision for depreciation 22,000 rupees, dividend income on investment 4,000 rupees, transfer to general reserve 5,000 rupees, preliminary expenses written off in the P&L account 1,000 rupees, profit on revaluation of investment 2,500. We are asked to calculate the funds from operation from the given details. So if you look into the nature of all the information that are provided, they are either non-operating or non-fund or non-operating and non-fund items. Let them be related to expenses or incomes, they fall within this given category. There is depreciation, though it is an operating activity, it is a non-cash item. And that's what about the specialty of this problem. So our job is to categorize the expenses and losses one side and the incomes on the other side, do the necessary adjustments for the same in the form of adjusted P&L account. So in this problem, I am going to discuss with you the preparation of adjusted P&L account through which we can very well calculate funds from operations. Fine. Now, if you look at the adjusted P&L account, the profit reported for the period is given in the debit side. I have written it in the debit side as the final figure. Fine, make sure you write it in the same way, because we are going to do only adjustment with this figure to arrive at the funds from operations, and that is why it should be written here. Let's get into the details of each and every item. Number one, loss on sale of equipment. It's a non-operating activity, and that's why it is debited here to loss on sale of equipment. Then similarly here, premium on redemption of debenture, it would have been adjusted in the P&L account. And after adjusting this figure, the reported income of 70,000 rupees for the year would have been calculated, and that is why it is presented here. So this is a non-operating item, and that is why it is debited there. Then discount on issue of debentures written off. That amount has been debited here in the adjusted P&L account because it's a non-operating activity. Depreciation on machinery, it's an operating expenditure but a non-cash and non-fund expenditure. Therefore, it has to be reversed, and that's why it is debited there. Then depletion of natural resources, it's very similar to depreciation on the normal fixed assets. So when the value of the natural resources is getting reduced, the name for the activity is nothing but depletion of natural resources. So it is a non-cash or non-fund expenditure to be added, and that is why it is debited there. Then amortization of goodwill, it is also a non-operating and non-cash expenditure to be added there and debited in the adjusted P&L account. Interim dividend paid, it's an appropriation out of profit. Of course, this profit has been arrived at after making due adjustment for interim dividend, and therefore this is a non-operating item and it comes in the nature of expenses, and that's why it has to be reversed and debited in the adjusted P&L account. So make it very simple. The next one, gain from sale of non-current assets. It's a gain. Fine. It would have brought in fund into the organization, but of course, it's a non-operating income and it has to be reversed and credited. See, look at it. The first item credited in the adjusted P&L account. The next one, excess provision for taxation will be returned back to the main pool of profit. So it is also treated as income, and it's a non-operating income. It has to be reversed and credited. And the next one, dividend income on investment is a non-operating income. It has to be credited. Transfer to general reserve, it is a non-operating activity, falls in the nature of expenditure, so it has to be debited in the adjusted P&L account. Then preliminary expenses written off, it is also a non-operating activity, falls within the nature of expenditure, it has to be reversed and debited, and that's why it is found over there. Then profit on revaluation of investments. When a company revalues its investment, it finds increase in its value, and that is what named to be profit on revaluation of investment. It would have been added with the revenues to have increase in the net profit. It is a non-operating income. It has to be reversed to calculate funds from operations, and that's why it has been credited there in the adjusted P&L account. I hope I have explained all these incomes and expenses fall within the category of either non-operating or non-fund and non-cash or non-operating and non-cash items. It's related with both incomes and expenses. Now let's have a look at the quick look at, you know, the adjusted P&L account. So after recording all these items, now finally we find balancing figure of 1,06,000 rupees in the credit side of adjusted P&L account, which is nothing but funds from the main operation of the business. You understand? To gain more idea about the basics of this particular calculation, funds from operation, watch my previous video. You can find that video in the playlist which is given in the description of the video. Title of the playlist is Funds Flow Analysis. You can find quite a good number of videos related to funds flow analysis in that playlist. You watch them and get benefited. Thanks for your time to watch this video. I'll meet you in another video. Bye for now, everyone. Good luck.